president of the United States.
Unfortunately, that didn't happen because I wasn't born here, but I definitely want to get into politics and I want to study law for sure. And I guess I'm good at talking to people, so.
Everything is possible. Right now, you are a leader. So.
What sports did you used to play?
I played football for a long time. That was basically like my main sport.
What position did you
play? I was a quarterback.
That's
awesome. It was a big part of my life,
yeah. So, what time do you do? Like, watch TV?
Sometimes, I mean.
With me?
With her?
Next
week. Real Housewives of Miami. Is there such a show? Never mind. Real Housewives of Orange County, I guess. And I don't know, I don't read that much, but I do a lot of after school activities, like leadership roles and, you know, retreats. I do a lot of retreats with the school.
Talk to her about that you did yesterday.
Oh, yeah.
Was really
yesterday I was in her retreat, a school retreat where we, like, help kids spiritually and teach them about God and stuff like that. So I'm Christian. I'm very open about that. I talk to people. Yeah. And I go to youth groups on Fridays. And
We used to go on retreats and I was like,
I love it. I mean, I'm a leadership leader. I mean, a leadership school leader. So I help them out and I teach them about God and stuff like that. So it's a big part of my life.
What do you guys like to do together as a mother son?
Everything.
We go to the movies a lot.
You know, I will answer you in Spanish. So, nosotros somos very good friends. I had him when I had 16, and we have to grow up together. And even we are mom and son, but we are like really close friends. And we go to the movies, we talk about everything. Pero la buena parte de esta relación es que yo soy un ser humano como cualquiera, tengo mis defectos, mis cosas, y él es esa clase de amigo que te dice, tienes que ser mejor en esto, tú puedes superarte en esto, me motiva muchísimo. Ayer hablábamos que a los 16 yo tuve que crecer para ser la mamá que él necesitaba, y él ahorita a los 18 tiene que ser más maduro de lo que es para ser el apoyo que yo necesito en mi vida en este momento. Así que yo pienso que esto es lo bonito de esta relación. Él da testimonio en su escuela de qué significa ser hijo de una madre adolescente, las cosas que significa para un niño crecer más rápido de lo necesario, porque tiene que crecer junto con su mamá, ser más maduro, y ahorita el ser un adolescente también, y motivar obviamente a los adolescentes a no tener embarazos antes de tiempo, a esperar y de pronto no ser madres a una edad que no debe de ser, pero también a motivarlas de que si en algún momento sucede, tanto hombres como mujeres tienen que seguir adelante obviamente con ellos. Entonces yo pienso que de toda la situación esto ha sido lo positivo de ellos.
No, definitely. I mean, we have a relationship is not only mother and son, it's more mother and, you know, really close friendship. My mom and I matured together, we grew up together. You know, even though my mom had me 16, I saw her grow up and mature into a young adult. And I had to mature at a young age too, and that was a big part of my life. And I think that it happens for a reason, and that's why now I guess I'm more mature and I can deal with other things. And I take care of my mom, she takes care of me. And whenever she needs me, I'm there for her. And whenever I need her, she's there for me.
Cute. Did you guys always live in Miami?
No, we didn't. We lived in Colombia until I was 9 years old, and then we came to the U.S. And it was tough in the beginning, but.
Yo me siento muy feliz de la oportunidad que Dios me dio de venir a este país. Nosotros somos inmigrantes, como la mayoría de personas latinas en Estados Unidos. Pero lo bueno de haber venido a este país fue darle la oportunidad a mi hijo de tener dos idiomas. Aunque entiende el inglés, a mí me da más dificultad hablarlo y pronunciarlo correctamente. Él habla perfecto inglés y español. Y el solo hecho de que él tenga esta ventaja me da mucha felicidad, porque digo, se logró la meta, y es la meta que muchas mujeres que dejan sus países, sus raíces, dejan todo, vienen a este país a luchar de cero, porque no es fácil venir a los Estados Unidos y empezar de cero. Muchas mujeres, yo vine acá estando sola, como madre soltera, con un hijo, nunca lo dejé en mi país, se vino conmigo a este país a empezar a trabajar, a buscar un sustento. Se necesita mucha fuerza porque no es fácil en un principio. Pero cuando tú ves a tu hijo 6 años después, a punto de graduarse del colegio, a punto de ir a la universidad, con un inglés y un español perfecto, con una mentalidad, una visión, un mundo lleno de posibilidades, tú dices, valió la pena. Y ese es el desafío que yo quiero dejarle a todas las mujeres sepan de que
si vale la pena cuando estamos en este país y luchamos por nuestros hijos. De pronto nosotros no alcanzamos todas las metas que queremos, pero las alcanzamos a través de ellos. Y por esa razón, ese es el mensaje para los adolescentes, para que sepan que nosotros como madres que hemos venido a luchar esperamos mucho de ellos. Que estudien, que progresen, que nunca se den por vencidos, que sigan obviamente ese mismo ejemplo que como nosotros traemos, pero que vayan a un nivel más superior al de nosotros.
Yeah, my mom is my motivation. Yeah. You know, she's the reason why I try hard. She's the reason why I still study. You know, it's not only for myself, but it's because she's done so much just for us to be here, yeah. Just for me to get the opportunities that I have today. You know, to be able to go to college. You know, to be able to have a great education. You know, two languages, Spanish and English.
Yeah.
Exactly. Want to make her proud, and I feel like if I don't fulfill everything, if I don't use everything that I have available to me, it's almost as if I'm not making her proud. Because
yeah.
She's giving me so much and giving so much of herself to me that it's almost my duty to do those things, you know? And I don't know, I'm so proud of my mom, and for me, a big part of my life was also, or nowadays, I also like to tell people to not have kids at a young age. I mean, that's a huge thing that's going on. And I actually made this film a while ago, recording my mom, and you know, she was like talking about how she had a kid at a young age and her struggles, and it's not easy. And we're just a story of something that happened, of a miracle, because that's really what it is. Because not everybody who has a kid at this age is very, has the relationship that my mom and I have.
And be successful.
Exactly, and has success. And yeah, you can have. I don't care if you don't have anything, as long as I have my mom and we have the love we have for each other. That's fine with me. You know. At the same time, I still thank her for just giving me to my cry. That's just the type of relationship that we have, and everything that I say is meaningful because it comes from the heart, because I don't have to rehearse it, because it's actually how I feel. And
eso es lo que no es fácil. La gente lucha mucho por tener dinero, fama, popularidad, cosas materiales, pero eso no es lo más importante en la vida. Lo más importante en la vida es sentirte realizado con lo mucho poco que tengas, que sientas que todo el camino que has recorrido, miras hacia atrás y dices, vale la pena. Y de pronto tengo que continuar luchando por lograr más, pero we're doing good together.
Yeah.
Y nos miramos y decimos, solo nos tenemos tú y yo.
Of course, I've learned that it's the little things in life that matter.
Yeah.
And that's how I live my life, and that's how I tell my mom all the time. Whenever something goes wrong, I'm there for my mom. It's the little things, you know. We have this. We have so many good things going on in our lives that one of those things is not going to change anything. We're really blessed to be here in the first place, because that's really the part where we're the most thankful, just to be in the U.S. and have the opportunities that we have. And when everything goes wrong, just think about those things. And I don't know. I think that everything that's happened in my life has made me really mature. So, it's made me who I am. And as a leader, it's really helped me, because that's something that I can use to help other people. And I love that. I love helping people. I love talking to people about God. I love talking to people about being better. And just and life in general and being a young adult is really important, because it's going to determine how the rest of your life is going to be.
Yeah.
So you have to make the right choices, exactly.
Are there any stories that your mom always tells you, like the same stories?
Well, she used to tell me that when I was little, obviously my mom can't succeed, so she used to play around with me. And when I was little, she used to eat ice on me. When I was in her belly, by the way. She used to eat ice on purpose so I could get hiccups, so she could feel me. So that's always made me nice. And when I was, my mom, when she was pregnant, she wrote a little journal where she writes everything that was going on, and that's just huge. That's been, I just know that from day one my mom loved me. You know how sometimes you think that some moms consider having an abortion or consider adoption. My mom never. At least, as far as I know, she never considered that, and that just makes me feel so sure of myself and so sure of the love that she has for me. So, I mean, that's something that I really thank her for.
I just love him so much. O sea, no sabía cómo explicar el amor que yo lo tengo ahí. Porque es mi motivación. La vida trae muchas dificultades, la vida trae muchos obstáculos, pero cuando tú tienes el amor o algo, alguien que te motiva, es la fuerza más grande que tú puedas tener. O sea, es algo increíble para superar cualquier cosa que sea. Y yo sé que fui mamá muy joven, pero Samuel ha sido una gran fuerza de poder dentro de mí. Y
I tell people, there's something that I realized. We've gone through hard times and we've gone through great times. And I tell my mom all the time, life is about perception. And the funny thing is that I was telling people that retreat the other day that life is all about perception. The way you see things is the way it's going to be. So if you're going through a tough got each other, and that's the biggest part. That's really all we need. And no matter what, no matter if it's only my mom and I or a bunch of people in our family, it's always going to be the same love, you know?
Yeah.
And that's my drive, and that's my motivation, as I said. So.
How does it make you feel like he's about to graduate now, and almost done, going to go to college?
Me siento muy orgullosa porque, o sea, siento que fue hace poquito que estaba en preschool, en el kindergarten, poniéndole las lentecitas, con su cabellito acá, es como que yo lo veo todavía como un niño, para mí es mi bebé, y ya ahorita va a punto de graduarse, lo veo buscando oportunidades dentro de la universidad, y lo veo, lo escucho hablar y me siento tan orgullosa. Me siento como que ha valido la pena todo el camino, todo el esfuerzo, todo lo que hemos vivido juntos ha valido la pena, porque si de algo estoy segura, yo ayer le decía a Samuel, hace como 4 o 5 años atrás que tú habías acabado de llegar a este país, que eras muy tímido, so shy, yo le decía, tú vas a ser un gran líder, tú eres especial, tú tienes algo que Dios te dio y vas a ser un gran líder, y 5 años después yo lo escucho hablar, la forma en la que él motiva a sus compañeros en la escuela, la forma en la que es un líder en la comunidad, la forma en la que habla. Yo le dije, ¿quién fue la primera persona que vio en ti un líder antes de que cualquier otra persona lo viera? Fui yo, tu mamá. Porque las mamás tenemos la capacidad de ver en los hijos cosas que los demás no ven. Y por eso yo desafío a todas las mamás que declaren sobre sus hijos cosas que van a hacer en el futuro, porque somos las únicas que tenemos el poder de poder declarar bendiciones para ellos en el futuro, de que ellos se crean en sí mismos las cosas que van a pasar en el futuro. Los jóvenes ahorita en las escuelas viven mucha opresión, mucho bullying, siempre en las escuelas están recibiendo cosas negativas de parte de los compañeros, de parte de pronto del sexo opuesto, incluso de parte de los profesores, y su autoestima es muy lastimada. Y los jóvenes crecen creyendo muy poco en sí mismos. Y por creer tan poco en sí mismos son muy vulnerables a malas decisiones, a drogas, a depresión, a baja autoestima, depresión. Y solamente uno como mamá puede hacerles creer a ellos mismos lo que es verdad, lo que está dentro de ellos. Es decirle, tú vas a hacer esto, tú vas a ser un líder, tú vas a crecer, tú puedes. E incluso cuando él en algún momento le repetía, no puedo, yo le decía, quiero que repitas, sí puedo. Y es nuestro deber como madres hacerles sentir eso a ellos, porque es nuestra responsabilidad el futuro de nuestros hijos.
My mom always told me that she would give me, and if she would give me, then I could see that she's going to help me with my
life. No, and if it wasn't for her, then I wouldn't be the way I am today. Yeah, I was shy. I've always been shy, and I still am. But I realized that one person can make a difference. And if I reject drugs, and if I say no to a lot of things that I should be doing, then I can be a good example to other people.
Yeah.
I really think it's important to be nice to everyone. And that's really how I am. People who know me know that I always smile. I'm always nice to everyone that I know because you make other people happy. And because of my mom, because of her telling me all the time, you're gonna be a good leader, you're gonna be good to people. I never believed in it. I thought I was always gonna be a shy kid. But I've come out of my shell and I realized that with my words and with my actions I can help a lot of people. And that's it goes the same way for everybody else. You know, and it starts now mostly in high school. And I want to tell that to every other teenager that I meet. I want to tell them that, man, just try to be nice to everyone, you know?
Yeah.
If you just do one act of kindness in one day, once a day, you're fine. So little things can make a huge difference. So.
Do you want to stay in Florida, like for college?
Yes.
I honestly want to stay. Not because I'm a mama's boy or whatever, but because I feel stable and my mom's giving me a stable home and a stable place. And even if I go up north, Florida, because I'm staying in Florida. I'm still going to talk to her, and I'm still going to drive down. And we have this tight bond that no one can break. And
nosotros somos una familia muy normal, muy del común denominador. No nos hace falta nada más, no es que nos sobren las cosas. Y él aquí tiene lo que necesita, que es su hogar. Todos los días estoy trabajando para que tenga un lugar donde estar, donde venga y estar tranquilo. Yo quiero que se enfoque en el estudio, quiero que esa sea su mayor prioridad. Yo cuando era más joven no pude entrar a la universidad porque ya era mamá y tenía que trabajar y era muy difícil para mí tener alguien que me pagara los estudios. Y me tocó esperar muchísimos años aquí ya tuviera un trabajo muy estable. Cuando llegué aquí a los Estados Unidos fue cuando me puse a estudiar periodismo en la Universidad de Miami con mi propio dinero. Y me tocó esperar mucho tiempo para poder tener esa oportunidad de prepararme y llegar a otro nivel, porque la preparación es fundamental para uno poder lograr algo en el futuro. Y yo le digo al Samuel, Samuel, a mí no me importa, yo trabajo, no me importa lo duro que me toque trabajar para que no te haga falta nada, más prométeme que siempre te vas a enfocar en tu estudio, en tener buenas notas, en entrar a la universidad, en terminar toda tu universidad completa, de no quit. No, don't quit, solamente
quit. Quitting for me is not a choice. It's almost not a choice because, first of all, college for me is extremely important, and school too, because my mom, fortunately, she paid my board fee, and I would be thankful to her for that for a long time, maybe forever, you know? And if it wasn't for that, I'm sure I would be in another place and very discouraged to go to college. But even if there's kids who go to school and they really put a lot of emphasis on school and grades and stuff, I encourage people to do that since freshman year and just start and try their best, because now I'm relaxed. Now I know that I can get into a youth school at least, you know, because I worked hard. And like I said, my coach was always my mom. She's always been. That's always my motivation. I always tell people, it's my mom, because she's really all I have. So other than that, it's just school is so important for me. And I know that once I get to school and I do my best and I succeed, I'm going to be able to pay for her stuff. That's what I want to do. I want the same way she paid for myself.
And you buy me a dress?
She's not one of like writing things. But the funny thing is that I'm also part of her because at the same time how I'm leaving high school and I'm going on to college, her career is also doing really well. So I'm almost looking at her as if in the same eyes she's looking at me, you know. Look at her, how well she's doing. I'm looking at her as if, like, my God, look at where she is now, look how hard she's worked. So and it's very proud of her.
Do you
guys want to
play this game? Okay, so I'm gonna tell you two things, okay, and then you choose one, okay?
Okay.
Okay, so Android or
Apple?
Yeah.
Okay, tennis shoes or Crocs?
No, tennis shoes.
We have to be at the same time, but I think we don't like Crocs.
No.
Okay, you can use Spanish.
Spanish.
I wish English.
I love Spanish.
I love Spanish,
like,
but I
would
love to speak more English. I just feel like...
Okay, Spanish for my girlfriend.
He just laughing so much when I try to speak English.
My mom, when she speaks English, I can't.
What?
She speaks very well. She's well spoken, but it's just, her accent is very funny. It's
he
cute.
Just said, like, I speak like Sofia Vergara.
Yeah, I mean, if anybody's ever watched Modern Family, I don't know if I can advertise on the.
So I get a little bit, like, embarrassing.
I don't think it's embarrassing. I think it's unique, and I love it. Whenever I tell people, hey, look, listen to my mom. Like,
what do you usually tell people before they meet your mom?
Dude, just prepare to be amazed and laughing, but because you think that such a beautiful woman is stuck up. I mean, most.
Just say I'm a beautiful woman.
You're a beautiful woman. You would think that she's very stuck up, but she's not. She's very. My mom is very down to earth, and I love that because my mom has taught me simplicity. And yeah, I could be very superficial and like a lot of superficial things, but I'm not. And neither is she. So that's a big part of that. I really like that. I like simplicity, and I don't like, you know, such things.
Okay. Latin American
food
or American
food? Oh, Latin American food. I will never change Latin American food.
Okay, football or soccer?
Football.
Yeah,
we have no football.
I can say football.
Broncos.
Mercedes Benz or BMW?
BMW.
Yeah,
sorry.
Yeah.
That's our car.
Totally.
And Facebook or Instagram?
Instagram.
She's obsessed with Instagram. So my mom is on social networking more than me.
Really?
Yes, she's on Twitter one. I don't even have a Twitter. She's on Twitter one. And
but because
one.
I have followers, and my followers, they really love me. They really fight for me and everything. Because believe it or not, even when I'm 33, I suffer like bullying, cybernetical.
Like cyberbullying.
Cyberbullying.
Yeah.
And I really feel exactly what a little kid in the school feels. Yo siento lo mismo que un chico en el colegio siente.
It's incredible. I've read things like, I just go on and people will be jealous, and my mom's a public figure and people know her, but people write the meanest things that I can never imagine. And it hurts me. And I just want to be like, mom, I can only imagine how my mom feels. And then at the same time, that's that person that, I think about it, I'm like, wow, we're so judgmental.
Yeah.
Everybody's so quick to judge. And nobody knows how she is. be like that. So that's also a good thing that neither one of us is like that.
Y me duele, ¿sí me entiendes? Yeah. Me duele porque ¿cómo es posible que alguien detrás de una pantalla o de un celular sin dar su cara pueda tener el dedo? Yo no estoy en contra de que alguien te diga algo que no esté de acuerdo porque cada quien tiene formas de pensar diferentes.
Eso es
de pero cuando hay palabras que duelen más que los golpes y cuando tú llegas a atacar de una manera tan fea, sea una figura pública, sea un compañero de trabajo, sea lo que sea, ocultando detrás un nombre ficticio y una cuenta ficticia para atacar, de verdad que es realmente algo malo. Y duele, no solamente le duele a la persona que lo hace, sino a los que te, a los que te aman. Pero lo lindo de todo esto es que es ahí cuando encuentras gente en las redes sociales que te aman, que te defienden, que alzan una voz en favor tuyo. Y yo sé que mis followers están ahí porque they love me, me apoyan, me defienden, son, tú no te imaginas, y, o sea, son lindos. Y por eso uso las redes sociales para bendecirlos. Me gusta poner en las redes sociales mensajes positivos. Me gusta poner en mis redes sociales mensajes que yo, cosas incluso que vivo en mi vida, para que la gente que esté allá afuera se dé cuenta que los que estamos en la televisión, o al menos en mi caso, no puedo hablar por los demás, pero en mi caso, aunque ese es mi trabajo, yo soy un ser humano común y corriente. Tengo necesidades, tengo momentos buenos, momentos malos, a veces lloro, a veces río. Siento de todo, como cualquier persona afuera, y me gusta poner mis experiencias para que la gente sepa que se puede identificar conmigo. Entonces me gustan las redes sociales y me gusta responderle a la gente porque pienso que tiene valor.
I never think that a public, like somebody with so many followers would actually message back. And when she learned how to use emojis, it was unbelievable. My mom would be putting little hearts everywhere.
Incluso yo, yo no sigo artistas de televisión.
She follows her fans.
Yo sigo mis seguidores. Gente que no sé quién es, pero que me sigue y me pone un mensaje que me llega al corazón, yo unfollow them back.
Yeah, I tell my mom, like, mom, you know, I tell her to put it on her, like, her social media, like, things that are inspirational. I tell her, like, you don't know how many people you can help just by putting one little thing. And when she writes back, that's a huge deal because a lot of people look at
yeah,
it means a lot. So that's something I'm so proud of my mom for. And she'll be like, she'll write back with those little emojis and hearts. She'll
make
like,
someone's day.
Yeah, it makes somebody want to, yeah.
And what sacrifices other than being here and having to work hard to pay for having a son, what other sacrifices do you think that you had to make in order to support what you're doing?
Al moverme acá, los Estados Unidos.
¿Qué sacrificios se tocó hacer para apoyar a los dos de nosotros?
Ah, muchos.
It's a lot. I mean, my mom, it's so many that I can't even tell you.
Yeah.
But at the same time, we have a lot of blessings and a lot of good things happen to us with a lot of good people. So it's just, we were fortunate, you know, and fortunate because I have a mom who works really hard, and fortunate because a lot of people came into our lives that helped us out. But other than that, it's just, yeah.
Sí, pero cada, como dice por ahí, cada esfuerzo y cada sacrificio tiene su recompensa.
Yeah.
Entonces, ha valido mucho la pena.
Yeah, it's, we're beginning to see that, you know, we're beginning to see how all her hard work has paid off.
You work. You
yeah,
go to the school.
I know my mom. I mean, I'm always here for my mom. My mom was telling me that, tells me that she can't believe how mature I am. I mean, my mom comes to me and talks to me about her problems. You know, it's almost that type of relationship. So she'll come to me and I'll give her advice. I'm a psychologist.
Yo le pido consejos, nos sentamos.
What do you think about this and that? And it's just, I love that because I almost feel like she doesn't baby me. This is what's going on. That's straight up. Yeah,
¿sabes por qué? Porque a veces como padres creemos que está mal pedirle perdón a nuestros hijos porque de pronto vamos a considerar que nos van a considerar menos. Y no, yo pienso que uno como papá, si no se equivoca, tiene que decirle a tu hijo, me equivoqué y te pido perdón.
I get more respect for her when my mom is real. When my mom is honest with me and when she doesn't have, when she's not prideful, she just says, look, I'm sorry, that was my mistake. So I can say that back to her, like, mom, you know what? It was my fault too, you know?
Y yo pienso que es bueno también cuando tu hijo es una persona grande y madura, decirle, ¿qué opinas de esto? Porque no hay un ser humano que te conozca más que tus propios hijos. Te conocen porque al final han estado ahí y tú dices, I know my mom.
Yeah.
Exacto. Y no hay un ser humano que te ame más que ese hijo. Y ese hijo es la persona, es la única persona que va a decirte la verdad. Porque ni siquiera los padres conocen tanto a sus hijos como los hijos conocen a sus padres. ¿Sí me entiendes?
Yeah,
qué divino.
Ay, qué
divino.
Okay. Add Jimena with X, Cordova with large B. I say right?
Uppercase. No, it's
just it doesn't matter.
Yeah. But anyways, I don't know. My mom and I like to go to the movies a lot, and I love.
Are we going to the theater movies today? That's right. Yeah. You have something else to do?
I might have plans, but. what do you call it? I love introducing my friends to my mom because she's such a cool person to be around. That my friends love her. I have friends who call her mom. And yeah, it's crazy. I have this friend who calls her like his sister. Yeah, and she's slowing down. He's like, "Where's my sister at?" Like, because my mom is like down to earth and we don't really talk anywhere. So.
Lo último que tengo que decir es que yo solamente deseo con todo mi corazón que la mujer que Dios o que Samuel se podría decir elija para su camino sea una mujer buena, que lo cuide, que lo respete, que lo ame y que pueda continuar haciendo de la gran persona que él ahorita es. Yo siempre le he dicho a él, Samuel, una mala mujer puede arruinar tu vida, una mala mujer puede echar a perder miles de cosas, tu futuro, tu presente. Yo siempre le digo, yo nunca voy a elegir por ti, porque al final eres tú el que te vas a enamorar y yo no voy a poder elegir. Pero digo, sé inteligente, no te dejes llevar por la pasión o por lo que ves al frente. Elige bien para que tengas una buena vida, un buen futuro.
Yeah, no, and I think as teenagers mostly we realize it through trial and error, you know. I've had my girlfriend and I've had my experiences, and yeah, I've had a girlfriend before who did not make me better, you know, didn't make me the best that I could be. And my mom was very supportive because never did she tell me you cannot date her anymore. And that was the best part because had she done that, then it would have pushed me away from her. My mom was very supportive.
You have to figure it out for yourself.
I had to figure it out for myself and she let me do that. And I figured it out. And I realized that the person who you're with, mostly as a young adult or as a teenager, is going to influence your life a lot.
Yeah.
You know, because you make a lot of decisions when that person is part of your life. And at this age, we fall in love and we're like, we almost get suffocated by the relationship, and it's the relationship. And we should be focusing on so many other things. You know, so I don't know. I think you almost get it out of the way. You have to have like that first girlfriend who you like fall in love with or whatever, and like just talk to her 24/7, and then whatever it happens, and then think you have, after that you learn to have a balance between, you know, school and friendship and stuff like that. I guess I'm bringing a girl to my mom is the most difficult thing. I just tell other people. My mom is very picky.
I'm very
picky.
She
thinks I'm the most good.
Yeah, that's true.
So
you're my baby.
Okay, I'm her baby.
You don't know how we.
No one can even touch me. Like I'm with a friend, and he'll be like, "What's up, dude?" My mom will be like, "Don't touch myself."
No, like that. That's eso es una exageración.
Okay, exactly.
Sí.
Solo
que trato de cuidarlo, ¿sí me entiendes?
That makes me feel good, because I feel loved, and I don't feel rejected.
Y trato de estar pendiente. Él a veces me dice, mami, me cuidas como si tuviera 15, una niña de 15 años, yo soy un varón y tengo 18.
I mean, I just turned 18, and I'll be going home, and I'm like, where are you? Alright, send me a picture. Trust me. I don't care because it's true, but we have a certain kids. I'll be hanging out with my friends, and my mom will be like, send me a picture of where you are. The worst thing is when she figured out how FaceTime worked, that just ruined my life. She would call me, okay, show me the surroundings, so I'll be like, okay.
But okay.
I think it's funny. Because I'm not embarrassed by it. Whenever one of my friends will be like, dude, my mom wants a picture, dude, you better pose. You better start doing it for
the pose. ¿Sabes por qué? Porque yo pienso que muchos padres están muy ausentes de la vida de sus hijos. Porque simplemente consideran que porque ya tienen cierta edad, ya no tienen nada que ver con ellos. Y yo pienso que es la edad en la que más uno tiene que cuidarlos. Yo pienso que ellos no tienen por qué sentirse mal, por el contrario, tienen que entender que es porque uno los ama, que es por la tranquilidad de uno. A mí sí me importa saber con quién está, y a mí sí me importa saber quiénes son las personas que están en la reunión, o en la casa de quién, o quién hay en la casa, a mí sí me importa. Y si de pronto me consideran que soy old fashion, por eso, aunque soy una mamá joven, no me importa. El hecho que yo sea una mamá joven no significa que sea una mamá libertina.
Yeah, no, that's true. My mom is very strict. Yeah, but no, there's one thing that I really think of to my mom for is that not too long ago she like spoke to my dad, my birth dad, and she told him how at this point in my life is the point that I needed him the most. And my dad and I haven't always been that close, and he's never really, we haven't been, you know, close, but my mom told him this, and now my dad's coming back into my life, and that's a huge part of my life, and I love that. And the only person I can thank for that is my mom, because if it hadn't been for her, then that wouldn't have happened. She wouldn't have, she told him, she talked to him on the phone, she said, this is the moment where you need to be here for him. You know, he's older now, he needs you here, he needs you at this time where he's needing you more than before, you know.
Sí. Esa es una parte muy difícil en nosotros, porque en algún momento cuando ya Samuel se volvió un adolescente más grande, él me dijo, me duele mucho no haber tenido realmente un papá en mi vida.
And you start to ask questions and you realize that I can only feel for kids who haven't really had a dad in their life. And it's not that my dad wasn't there, and he was, but at the same time it's that feeling of having your dad and your mom in your house and feeling like they love each other and, you know, stuff like that. And the funniest thing is that throughout my whole life, you always wish that they were together again. You know, it's like something that a kid always wishes, like, oh my God, I wish my parents were together. And then when you grow old, you realize that it's not for the best. But as I started to grow up a few years ago, I would tell my mom, like, I'm so sad about this because I feel like, you know, it's not that he hasn't been there, but I wish he was there, you know? But now my mom thinks of her and thinks of my dad, you know, he's changed and now he can be a part of my life, and that's something that makes me really happy.
Yo le dije a él que si a mí como mamá me tocaba pedirle perdón a él por el hecho que no hubiera tenido a su padre ahí, yo lo hacía. Y le dije, perdóname, porque yo no quería que, le decía, yo no quiero que tú tengas dolor en tu corazón, por eso te amo tanto, que no me importa tener que pedir por algo, pedir perdón por algo, que de pronto no me correspondería pedir perdón, porque aunque yo hubiera tratado como mamá soltera de ser mamá y papá al mismo tiempo, yo sé que es imposible reemplazar el vacío que un padre deja en la vida de un hijo. Pero yo le dije a él, coge lo mejor que te ha dado la vida, úsalo para el bien de los demás, para el bien tuyo, y úsalo a tu favor, usa las circunstancias, úsalo a tu favor y move forward. Y cuando hablé con el papá de él, yo le dije, ahorita es cuando Samuel más te necesita. Él dijo, ya para qué, ya tiene 18. Yo le dije, no, ahorita es cuando más un niño necesita de su papá. Y esa es la regla que los adolescentes más necesitan de sus padres, no es la regla que ellos...
Yeah, no. That's what you need most. And I think that as teenagers, and I know this is the same for everybody else, we start to look for someone to blame for everything that's happened in our lives, you know. And I was looking for someone to blame because it wasn't necessarily my dad's fault, it wasn't necessarily my mom's fault, or anybody's fault, you know. Things just don't work out. We don't understand those things because we haven't lived life. But we want to blame someone. We just don't understand it. And thankfully, my mom told me a very wise thing, which was get the best out of both of your parents. Take the best out of your dad, and take the best out of me, and take the best out of life. And that's where I come again and say that life is about perception, and the way you see life is the way it's going to be. So, I don't know. I took the best out of my mom, take the best out of my dad.
Take the
good and leave the bad, and you go with what you got, you know? And that's awesome.
Do you have any advice for teenagers that want to be a reporter or a media spokesperson, someone?
Just be like you. You are really good. Really good and amazing report. Really. You did have an amazing interview. You touched my feelings. You almost made me cry. You did the right questions.
Yeah, that's the most important part.
You know what? You have a great future. And the magazine is doing something great because give the opportunity to the teenagers to do something like that. You know, not todos los presentadores o los reporteros tienen la capacidad de mover sentimientos en la gente. Y tú lo hiciste en estos minutos. Tienes una gran habilidad para entrevistar. Nunca dejaste de mirarnos a los ojos. Sentí que sentías todo lo que nosotros estábamos sintiendo. Y eso es increíble, porque tienes un gran talento. Y la revista, lo que está haciendo es increíble por los adolescentes, porque les dando la oportunidad a ustedes de demostrarse de cuánto son capaces de hacer. Increíble, de verdad que felicito la revista y te felicito a ti por una entrevista tan maravillosa.
I'm just for Brazilian.
Yeah.
You know Spanish very well, so that's awesome.
Yeah, I understand.
You could go together to the movie.
I don't touch my baby.